Sheikh Farouk Edema, County Sheikh of Lodonga Muslim Community, also the chairperson of the Central Organizing Committee for the function, said the celebration will be held on October 1st, 2022 at Alilinga in Kuru Sub-County, which is the historical place where the first Muslim convert was circumcised. He said they have a budget of about 45 million to cater for the day.
It is for the organization of a function to mark 100 years of Islam's existence in Yumbe. And as a COC, we are working tooth and nail to ensure that the function is successfully organized. And we're expecting over 2,000 people to attend that function, because it's going to be a very big function.
Sheikh Swaib Alahai, Achinga District Kadi of Yumbe, said Islam was brought in the district by then Aringa County in 1916 by Sultan Fadumullah Ali Adu, a son of Aringa who was taken as a slave by the soldiers of Emin Pasha to Ethiopia. He said Adu, while in Ethiopia, converted to Islam, and when they were freed, he came home as a Muslim.
Elder brother, our grandfather Fadumullah Adu, brought Islam in Yumbe since 1916, after coming from being in Ethiopia by the army of Emin Pasha. He came and staged Islam here in Yumbe, so that people impress the Islam during his time. And alhamdulillah, the majority of the people are Muslims. We thank Almighty Allah for that.
Sheikh Swaib said Islam makes over 90% of the population in the district today. According to the Qadi, the number of mosques in the district has massively increased from less than 10 in the 1920s to over 250 mosques today,
which those people used for spreading Islam, mats for praying, even footmarks which they wore, or they are using for ablution all the around. So that day, inshallah, we call for all brothers and sisters to come and see this historical event, inshallah ta'ala.
Mahad Angudipi, Juma Youth Coordinator for the district, said the youths are in the forefront of the organization to celebrate the day.
Well, other contributions of the youth, not only mobilization. We said, as youth, we have set a lifetime vision for this project. We want this to be something that has come to stay, and it is forever, for generations and generations to come. First of all, we have taken the lead in drafting the comprehensive master plan for the site. We went to site and we found the land is about 29 acres. This needed planning, and I, as a physical planner, have taken lead, plus with the whole of my other youth.
Report by Adam Gule for the news.